पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ नीलाम्बुजश्याबलकोमलङ्गं सीतासमारोपितवामभागम् पाणौ महासायकचारुचापम् नमामि रामं रघुवंशनाथम्। Adoration's Lord Rama, whose complexion is like the blue lotus, very tender and delightful in appearance. Sita is seated on his left side and he is carrying powerful bow and arrow in his hands. Sri Ram Charitmanas, Aranya Kanda, and verse number 10. It continues. Presently, the context is Sri Rama has visited Sutikshana's ashram. Rama, Sita, Lakshmana, they are all together. And Rama is on his way to looking for a more steady residence that he will find in Panchadashi, rather Panchavati, not Panchadashi, Panchavati. Presently, Sutikshna is offering prayers to Rama. His Ram Stuti is very profound, and that's where our focus is at least on this day. Sudikshna is a disciple of sage Agastya. Nirguna Saguna Vishamastam Rupam Jnana Gira Gotitam Anupam Amalam Akhilam Anavadyam Aparam Nami Ram Banjanamahi Bharam. O Rama, you are Nirguna, Sagun, Visham, Sam, these are all your different aspects. Nirgun is Nirgun Nirakar. Sagun, Sagun Sakar and Sagun Nirakar. These points I have mentioned before, they are very important to understand. You begin with your love or devotion to God by practicing meditation on the form of God. But God has no form. Any form we adopt is allegorical. So, however, you must adopt that which is supports your mind. And that which supports is a practical reality. God with name, form, and attributes. So, all Sagun forms, Rama, Krishna, Buddha, Jesus, all forms, they are the first step. But as you advance, form moves away and go after the spiritual qualities such as compassion, all permeating, all love, and so forth. But if you advance further, you enter into the stage of Nirgun Nirakar, God without form and without attributes. Because you begin to understand, even when you speak of God as Sat-Chit Ananda, you are using mental concept about Sat-Chit and Ananda. And concepts are far from reality. So, for deeper revelation, you dive into silence. These points have been brought out by these words, Nirgun, Sagun, Visham. Visham means not exactly the same. That form that goes on changing. You start your meditation, turn your mind to Ganesha to begin with, then it shifts from Ganesha to your deity, and suddenly your mind switches to Lakshmi Devi because your money is in trouble, or Saraswati Devi because you have to pass to appear at a test. So that's called Visham. But no matter how Visham, you must understand the same God is being worshipped. And there is no harm in shifting the mind from one aspect to another. Rather, it's very helpful. So in spite of Visham, God is Samarup, is always the same. God is Anupam, incomparable, Nirmal, taintless, free of all modifications, infinite, and reliever of the burden of your mental stress. Bhakta kalpa padada padapa rama tarjan koko the loba madhakama atinagar bhavasagar he say tu tratu sada dinakar kul ketu. You, O Lord, you are an orchard of kalpa viksha, wish yielding tree. Not one tree there, it's a whole orchard there. And you cause terror in the heart of anger, greed, pride, lust. This is an allegorical term. Consider these vices, these impurities as personalities. And they dominate your mind like ghosts sitting in different directions. In your mind, anger here, greed here, the whole house of your mind here. You lost all the peace. But turn your mind to Rama, and Rama creates terror in the heart of the anger. So anger is so frightened by Rama, it will not dominate your mind. Greed is so frightened that it will move away from your mind. All impurities, no matter how dominating they are, they simply fade. Atinagar bhavasagar setu tratu sadadin karakul ketu. Supremely skilled, and you are like a bridge to cross over the ocean of the world process. You are the banner of Suryakul, of the solar race. May you protect me always. Banner of solar race means you are the gateway to entire Uttarayana movement. Agni Jyotiyaha Shukla Sanmasa Uttarayana Atulita Bhuja Pratapa Balad Dhamaha Kapimala Vipul Vibhanjana Namaha Dharma Narma Dharma Varma Narmada Gunagramaha Santata Sham Tanotu mama ramaha. The strength of your arms is incomparable. You are the abode of strength. Your name is the destroyer of greatest of sins that are promoted by Kali Yuga. You are the armor of Dharma. Your virtuous qualities, they promote mystic spiritual delight. O Rama, may you pave the way to unceasing goodness, kalyan. Yadapi viraj vyapaka vinasi, sabke hirday nirantar basi, tadapi anuj shishadi sahit kharari, basatu manasi mamakana nachari. Though you are nirmal, pure, devoid of all impurities, vyapak, all-permeating, avinashi, indestructible, imperishable, immutable, and you abide in the heart of everyone, yet, O destroyer of demon khara, Sri Rama, abide in my heart with Lakshmana and Sita, you who are passing through the forest. May you abide in my very heart. This is a subtle mystic key to securing devotion to God. Mystic key is Sagun Sakar. Adopt Ishta Devata. Choose first, be initiated into Ishta Devata, Ishta Mantra, like Rama, Krishna, whomsoever. Once you have that Ishta Mantra, now that divine set of Rama should become your most fascinating God, and that's the simplified version is Rama, on one side is Sita, on the other side Lakshmana. And there is a more extended version later you will find. Hanuman constantly adores Rama. Ram Lakhan Sita Sahin Hirdaya Basavu Hanuman. Tikshna simply says, may you abide in my heart with Lakshmana and Sita. All your spiritual progress is secured. Your integral yoga movement will be perfectly effective. But if devotion is not secure, then it is not effective. You may think you are doing lots of sadhana, but you are empty internal. Je janahi te janahu swami, sagun agun uru antar jami, yoko shalapati rajyo nayana, karau suram hirdaya mama ayana. Those who have great knowledge about yagra sagun, sagun sakar, Saguna Nirakar, Nirguna Nirakar, and your divine qualities such as omniscience, omnipotence, let them follow their devotion. But for me, O Rama, lotus-eyed, abide in my heart the way he has invoked Rama. Asa abhiman jai jani bhore, main sevak prabhupati pati more. May I never lose the pride. Here pride refers to spiritual pride, which is commendable. What the pride? That I am the servant of Rama, and Rama is the Lord. And it is this aspect that gives you inner strength. There's three aspected relationship. Later Hanuman asked the question, rather Rama asked Hanuman, how am I related to you? Deha buddhyatu dasoham. On the point of view of your bodily identity, you are just a slave. God is the master. From the point of view of your soul, you are like a ray. And God is like the sun. And from the absolute point of view, you and God both are one and the same. But you began with, I am a das, and Lord is the master. God is Swami. Shrima Rama was highly pleased. He enfolded Sutikshna in his arms. Param prasanna janu muni mohi yo barmagav deu sotohi. O sage, I am very pleased with you. Ask any boon and I will grant that boon to you. Muni kaha barb kabahu na jacha samujhina parai jhoot ka sacha. Sutikshna said, you will find Sutikshna is showing exceeding cleverness of a devotee, trying to trick God as it were. That's all allegorical. Says, I never intended to ask for any boon because I'm not secure. What should I ask? Whatever I ask, is it right or is it wrong? Is it limited? Or is it a cause of distraction? I don't know what is false and what is real. What should I ask and what I shouldn't? Tumahi nik lagai raghurai so mohi dehu dasa sukhadai. You are the delighter of your servants. So, give what you wish to give. Avirala bhagati bharati vijnana ho sakal gun jnana nidhana. And Sri Rama said, O sage, may you be endowed with profound devotion, vairagya, dispassion, vijnana, intuitive knowledge, and may you become the abode of all divine virtues and abode of wisdom itself. You are being given what the ideal that you are working for. Your spiritual progress is characterized by these great virtues. Devotion, dispassion, intuitive wisdom, divine virtues, Devi Sampat. These are the things that you must work for. Prabhu jo din so baru mein paava, ab so dehu mohi jo bhava. As I said, Sutikshna was very clever. Says, O Lord, you have given me what you wanted to give. Now, give me what I want. Anuja Janaki Sahita Prabhu Chapabana Dhara Ram Mamahiya Gagana Indu Iva Basahu Sadani Shikam. O Rama, may you abide in the firmament of my heart. My heart is like the sky. and your presence like the full moon. And the presence implies, may you abide in my heart, you along with Sita Devi and brother Lakshmana, equipped with bow and arrows, and may you abide with perfect steadiness. Eva mastu kari rama nivasa, harashi chale kumbhajari shipasa. Now Lord Rama said, eva mastu, let it be so. And Rama, who is Rama Nivasa, consort of Goddess Lakshmi. Lakshmi is Sita Devi, and Rama is Vishnu. That's one aspect of Rama. In a deeper level, still deeper level, Rama is Brahma, Sita is Maya Shakti. Now they proceeded towards the ashram of sage Agastya. Bahut divas guru darshan upaye, bhaye mohi yahi ashram aaye. And as I said, Sutikshna was very clever. Now Sutikshna says, I have not had darshan of my guru Agastya for a long time, and therefore I will be also accompanying you, O Rama. Ab Prabhu Sangha Jao Guru Pahi, Tum Kaha Nath Nihora Nahi. Now with your company, I will go to meet my Guru. And for this, I don't need you to seek your boon. Dekhi Kripa Nidhi Muni Chaturai, Liye Sangha Bhiyase Do Ubhai. Rama saw sage's divine cleverness and smilingly let him accompany the Lord. Both brothers were laughing. Panth kahat nija bhagati anupa, Muni ashram pahunche surabhupa. On the way, Rama gave more insight into bhakti yoga, the path of devotion, and finally reached the sage's ashram, Agastya's ashram. Turat sutikshan guru pahi gayehu, kari dandavat kahat asabhayehu. Sutikshna went ahead to inform sage Agastya, and having prostrated before the Guru, he said, Nath Koshaladhish Kumara, Aye Milan Jagat Adhara. O Lord, Sutikshna is talking to sage Agastya, his Guru. O Lord, King Dasharatha, the son of King Dasharatha's son, Rama, who is the support of this entire universe, he along with Lakshmana and Sita have come to meet you. It is he whom you are devoted to day and night. Sunata Agasti Turata Uthidhaye, Hari Boloki Biloki Lochana Jalachaye. Immediately Agastya got up with great joy, and having darshan of Rama before his eyes, tears began to roll from his eyes, tears of joy. Both brothers fell at the feet of Agastya, and Rishi lifted them up and folded them in his arms. Sadar kushala puchi muni jnani, asana bar baithare, baithare aani. having asked for the well-being, how are you, etc., this like normal courtesy. And then let Rama and Lakshmana and Sita sit on a seat close by. And Agastya said, having offered worship of Rama, that no one is more lucky than me today because I have the darshan of your divine presence. Jahan lai rahe apar muni vrinda, harshe sab viloki sukha kanda. And all the other muni, saints, etc., who were there in the ashram of Agastya, they all were thrilled to have darshan of Rama. Muni samuha mahi mahabait, muni samuha bait ebta sanmukha sabaki or sarad indu tana chitavat manahu nikara chek chakor. Sri Rama is seated, and all the sages, saints, their attention is focused on Rama, and they are so thrilled, as if assembly of chakora birds are gazing at an autumn full moon. Tab Raghubir kaha muni pahi, tum san prabhu durav kachu nahi. Sri Rama then said to sage Agastya, O sage, nothing is hidden from you. You know the cause. Tum jano yahi karan aayam, tate tat nahi kahi samujayam. You know the cause of my coming, and therefore I have not explained that in detail. Ab so mantra dehu prahu mohi, yahi prakar maro muni drohi. Now please advise me, how am I able to destroy demons who are enemies of saints and sages? Muni muskane suni prabhu bani, Puchehu nath mohika jani. Sage Agastya smiled and said, O Lord, what have you thought about me that you have asked this question? Have you thought that I am stupid? Implying you are yourself omniscient. You know already, but you are asking, and we will maintain the courtesy. Tumhare bhajan bhaj prabhav adhagari, janahu mahima kachuk tumhari. And all that I know about you is based on my worship of you. Umari taru vishala tava maya, phala brahmanda aneka nikaya. Your maya is like a mighty tree of plums, and the plums, each plum is a brahmanda, is a universe. Jiva chara chara jantu samana, bhitar basai na janahi ana. All living beings, movables, immovables, all jivas, they abide in this tree of the world process. Te phala bhakshak kathin karala, tav bhaya darat sadav sukala. And you abide in all these gular fruits, implying in a very allegorical way, all jivas are like different fruits, and the seed behind the fruit is God Himself. Even time is ever terrified by your presence. Your time relating to God of death. Te tum sakal lokapati saim, phunche humohi manuj ki naim. You are that great God, the Lord of all the universe, the ruler of all souls, the indweller in every heart, and you are asking me like a common human being. Yah barmano kripa niketa, basavirden shi anuj sameta. I seek this boon from you, O God. May you abide in my heart along with Sita Devi and Lakshmana. May you abide forever. Avirala bhagati bhar virati satsanga charana saroru priti abhanga yadyapi brahma khanda ananta anubhav gamya pajahi jahi santa. Though you are indivisible, infinite, to be known by intuitive knowledge, and you are worshipped by all saints and sages, yet I need this boon, the boon of avirala bhakti, profound devotion, vairagya, dispassion, satsanga, good association, and unflinching love towards your lotus feet. These points are repeated again and again, that must be hammered in your mind. These are the great ideals that your mind must always work for. And don't get lost with the worldly worries and anxieties. You must handle worldly responsibilities in all detail, but don't get lost in them. You are an instrument in divine hand. Astava rupa bakhanam janam phiri phiri saguna brahma ratimanam. Though I understand your absolute form, neti, neti, not this, not this, beyond time, space, causation, transcendental, yet I want to have love for Saguna Brahman, Saguna Sakar. You are always congenial to your devotee. May you give this boon. Hai Prabhu Paramat Manohar Thaun Pavana Panchavati Tehi Naun Dandaka Ban Punita Prabhu Karahu Ugrasap Munivarakarahu. Now coming to the practical point, Rama had asked where he should abide for destroying the demons. And Agastya is saying that there is a sacred spot. The name is Panchavati. In that Dandaka Ban, Dandaka forest, mystically Dandaka forest, is where you receive mystic danda. Danda literally relates to punishing rod, but mystically it is not punishment, it is investing the personality with all divine virtues. Da plus anda. Anda is your personality. Da, dama, dan, daya. The three da You begin to assimilate. The more you assimilate, the more you are carrying the danda. Until danda becomes your highlight of your personality. So, sanctify this dandak ban by abiding in Panchavati. And Panchavati again is mystically Ti Bhati Priya Nam Roop. Put it in more simple way, Satchit Ananda plus name and form. These five terms put together is that spot. Live with that understanding that you are sustained by Satchidananda. Names and forms are maya, illusory. The more and more understand names and forms are illusory, the more and more the divine in you begins to shine. Bas karahu taha ragukul raya, kije sakal muni ne paradaya, chale ram muni aya supai, turtahi panchabate ni arai. There, O Rama, abide and shower your compassion on all the sages and saints. Having received Agastya's instructions, Rama, Lakshmana, Sita, and all his associates, they proceeded towards Panchavati. And at this stage, I will conclude. Om. Om. Ram, 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 Ram. Om, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om. Prayer for shower of Karuna, Mayaras, grace of God over all of you, with the blessings of Shakti, Bhakti and Mukti. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe, Sugantim Pushti Vardhanam, Urvarukmuva Bandhanan, Mrityor Mukshyama Amrita, Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchid Dukhbhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Hari Om.